Good morning, beautiful people. It is the credit score plug. Yes, it is. I do apologize for those of you that are in my credit repair group or my credit repair DIY group that I am growing. I want you guys to know that it is going to be lit. However, I have so much on my plate that I'm trying to learn at one time. I'm learning the travel business as well as this credit repair business. So it is a lot to take in. But just please be aware that the information and the, you know, the amazingness, it is coming, but please give me a moment to get that up and running. I'm also looking for other people who can help me with that, people who have knowledge of the credit repair business or people who are interested in learning about the credit repair business that can actually help me in this group be able to answer questions and all of this, because of course by me running my travel business as well as running this credit repair situation that I'm trying to get off the ground, it's a lot that I'm trying to do. So I'm trying to find other people who are like-minded who wouldn't mind helping as well. So I'm on the hunt for that. So if you're one of those people out there who is interested in learning more about credit repair, if you do not mind, you know, studying and learning and that type of thing, we all need to realize that the credit repair business, it is a million-dollar industry, because guess what? We always, I don't care if you're a million years old, okay? If you die when you 99,999, I don't care. Your credit is going to follow you until the day that you're put into the ground. Period, point blank. So people are always going to need credit repair advice and credit repair services. But the nugget that I wanted to come and give you guys before I go on my little tangent, because I know everybody's not here to hear my tangents, but you guys know I like to sit down and talk to you guys. I want to let everyone know to please go, if you have not checked your credit report in a while, you get one free credit report every single year. You can go out. As a matter of fact, I'll leave that down below. It's annualcreditreport.com. I think that's the name of it. But I'll find that link and put it down in the description box down below. If you have not gotten your free credit report in the last 12 months, you are entitled to one free credit report every single year. Okay, what I want you guys to do is go over and get your free credit report. After you get that free credit report, I want you to analyze your address. Look at the information that's on there. Make sure that your name is correct. Make sure that your addresses are updated and correct, because oftentimes they'll have addresses that you haven't lived at for 15, 20 years. Okay. And not all the time, but sometimes, okay, very often, it depends on the individual situation, but you can easily increase your credit score from 20 to 60 points by updating some of those old addresses on there. This one young lady reached out to me and she was like, thank you so much for telling me to update my address. She went and checked her credit report. And that's one thing that a lot of people don't do. They don't go and check their credit report often enough. And she actually saw her sister's name on her credit report. Do you know how much that can affect your credit score? What if your sister went out and, you know, was being a little devious with her spending, wasn't really paying her bills, and her information was on your credit report? That's affecting you not only financially, but that's affecting you from being able to go and do things that you need to do for yourself. Okay, so definitely make sure that you're checking your credit score, your credit report often. Okay, like I said, if you are a United States citizen, you are entitled to one free credit report every 12 months. I'll leave that link down in the description box. And I will also, this is something that you guys can do online. You can actually go online and dispute your and update your information. Also, you can also call that in. Okay, I don't think, from my research and a little bit of learning that I have done, I don't think that's something that you need to write a letter for, etc. I mean, you can, however, you can easily just call them on the phone, or you can there is a link that I'll put in the description box as well for all three credit bureaus, where you guys can go over and you can submit that information online. Okay, because like I said, not, it doesn't mean that your credit score is going to go up, but there are a lot of people who, when they update that information, it does increase their credit score anywhere from 20 to 60 points. So my thing is this, why not at least update that information anyway? Because you do not need all of those old addresses on your credit report. And I always tell people this as well. The credit bureaus, they don't care what you have in your bank account. They don't care what you got in your wallet. They don't care how much money you make. They don't care about any of that. The only thing that they care about is what's on that credit report. And oftentimes, those old addresses and things like that, and those old aliases, especially for men, a lot of times a man will have junior on the end of his name. However, he's not a junior, and that can affect your credit score as well. So you need to make sure that you're updating that information and making sure all of that information is accurate, because sometimes you may be a junior and they may have your information mixed up with your father's information or your son's information. So you definitely need to make sure that you're checking your credit reports at least annually. Okay. For those of us who, if you're a United States citizen, you get a free credit report. So why not take advantage of that? You do not have to pay any money. Like I said, as a citizen, you are entitled to one free credit report every 12 months. That link will be down in the description box, like I said, you guys. And I will also put the phone numbers as well. You guys can easily just call Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax and get this information updated. They may tell you to send in fax in proof of your current address. They may also ask you to fax in your social to make sure you're who you say you are, and that's a security measure because you don't want any random person calling into these credit bureaus pretending to be you. So of course you want to you want to take advantage of that if they do ask you to provide that proof, okay? But definitely do that, okay? Like I said, it doesn't cost you any money to do. Go and update your address with all three credit bureaus, Experian, TransUnion, and Equifax. Or you can do that online, or you can call it in. Okay, like I said, that can easily increase your credit score from 20 to 60 points, depending on the individual situation. And also make sure that you're checking those names, because those names, if they're messed up, or if you have a wrong middle name, or even if you see somebody else's name on your credit report, get that stuff off of there, get that stuff updated, because that can help your credit score very, 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 very easily. I just had to come and give you guys that little bit of a nugget because I was talking to somebody who DM'd me from the credit repair group asking me that question. And I was like, yes, go and update all of that information, because even myself last year, thank God I'm done paying Sallie Mae. Oh my God, family. If you ever have the opportunity to get those student loans off of your credit report, if you can negotiate a payoff balance or something like that, thank God for Jesus, and thank God I didn't owe that much to the student loan company, because thank God my father and my mother, they did pay for some of my schooling, so I didn't have to get a whole gang of loans. But that I did get. One thing about Sallie Mae, a lot of times you can get stuff like that removed from your credit report, but it's very hard, especially when they pass that debt off to the government. They will take your income tax money. I don't get any income tax money anyway. I have to pay taxes every year because I am an independent contractor and I am looking for a literal accountant, for real. That's one thing that I'm doing, because I purchase a lot of stuff for my home-based business and I need to take advantage of some of those deductions and stuff. So I'm not going to be doing my taxes anymore. No, because I got too much going on and I ain't trying to learn the tax business too. I ain't doing that. So I'm going to find me a good accountant, somebody who knows what they know, so that they can help me with my taxes every year so that I don't have to pay a buku amount of money. So, and that's another thing. Y'all know I go on my little tangents. So before I go on my tangent really quickly, make sure that you're going and updating those addresses. Links and phone numbers will be down in the description box. You can easily do it online, or you can call into the credit bureaus and update that information that way, and you can increase your credit score 20 to 60 points. Now let me go into this little tangent. For those of you guys that asked me about being an independent contractor, you will need to make sure that for every time you get paid, you don't have to do it every time. It would, you know, your own personal situation depends on how much you want to put back and when you want to put it back. But if you're working for yourself, if you're a business owner, if you're an independent contractor, not an employee, independent contractor, make sure you're putting away a certain amount of money every month. It doesn't matter. It depends on your personal situation. You could put away $100. You could put away $150. So that at the end of the year, when you file your taxes, you don't have to come up with a whole huge lump sum of money to pay Uncle Sam. All right. Granted, you can, you know, make payment arrangements and stuff with Uncle Sam, and you can pay him that way. However, nobody wants an extra bill. So just make sure that you're putting that money away. And that's one of the costs of being your own boss. You're going to have to pay the piper one way or another. Okay. So just make sure that you're putting money away every single month. Some people do it every week. That way, at the end of the year, you actually have money, a lump sum of money that you can actually pay your tax bill, okay? That's if you're an independent contractor. If you're working at home and you're an employee for a company, they actually deposit money into your account and they deduct taxes from it. So you don't have to worry about putting money away in that sense because you're already paying taxes out of your paycheck. But if you're an independent contractor, it means that the person that you're working for, the person that you're contracted with, they're not taking out any taxes. So they're giving you all of your money. So just make sure that if you're an independent contractor, if you're working from home, depending on how much money that you're making every year, Make sure you're putting that money aside so that at the end of the year, when it's time to do your taxes, you already have that money saved up and you don't have to worry about, oh my God, I got to come up with, you know, X, Y, Z in order to pay Uncle Sam. You don't have to do this. So just make sure you're putting that money to the side. That way you already have that squared away if you're a business owner. Okay. What else did I want to talk about? Oh, I just left the gym. Girl, let me tell you, I actually met one of my subscribers in the gym. I am so family. I thank you guys for actually speaking to me. Like this one lady, I'm still mad at you, boo. I'm mad at you. She saw me down there at the casino down there in Mississippi, and she was like, you know, you look just as beautiful in person as you do on camera. She was like, I didn't speak. Why didn't you speak to me, girl? Speak to me. I know that I said I'm a little bit shy and a little bit, you know, I get a little antsy and stuff, but speak to me. I promise you, after you speak to me, after I warm up to you, we will be the best of friends. So if you ever see me in person, speak to me, say hi, give me a hug, all of that good stuff. But I met this young lady in the gym today. Oh my God, I have no idea what that was. It sounded like something just blew up, girl. Scared the absolute crap out of me. But that's one of the reasons why I'm so late getting back to my whole little situation, because I have to go into Dollar General right now because I have to get some personal items. But I was in there running my mouth with her for about 2 freaking hours. Okay, I was walking on the treadmill. I had already almost got to my 4 hours because I get up like really early in the morning and go to the gym because I have so much that's going on in my life right now, and I thank God for that. I thank God that I'm so busy, because we all know that an idle mind is the devil's playground. I know that all too well. Okay, when your mind is idle, the devil loves to mess with you and likes to poke, you know, poke at you and all this stuff, and have you have all type of negative thoughts running through your mind. So I am so glad that my days and my nights are busy. I do not mind being busy. I appreciate the busyness, because again, an idle mind is the devil's playground, and that's the last thing that I want, is for the devil to be messing around with me, girl. We all know that I've dealt with depression and anxiety and all that stuff in the past, and thank God for Jesus, like I said, that I haven't dealt with that in a very, very long time. Don't get me wrong, I have bad days sometimes. I'm not gonna sit there and try to make it seem like I don't have bad days, but my good days far outweigh my bad days, and that ain't nothing but by the grace of God. I know that for a fact. So, but yeah, if you ever see me in person, definitely say hi, give me a hug or something. Let's have some conversation. I think I have me a new workout buddy. I'm not sure, because she said that she doesn't normally come to the gym that early in the morning, because like I said, sometimes I get up anywhere from 4 to 4:30 in the morning and go to the gym, because I like to start my work day at about no later than 6:30. So by the time I get to the gym, I do my 4 miles. I might go over to the 60-second weight machine things and do, you know, maybe 15-20 minutes on that, and then I'm back home in the shower and I'm in my office working. So that is what I'm normally doing. And she said she doesn't normally come that early in the morning. Only reason she came early in the morning today was because something about her husband had to go somewhere and he had to use the car or something. I forgot, but she explained all that to me. But we actually were standing in there. We were having a conversation for over an hour. Thank you so much, boo. I think I got me a new friend. I'm so happy. Y'all know I ain't got no friends, girl. Like I said, anybody in my area. And that's another thing. I need me some travel girlfriends. Like, I need me some business-minded women who are, you don't even have to be in my immediate area. I don't care where you are. You could be in Atlanta, New York. You can be in Florida. It does not matter. I want some business-minded women who actually want to travel and make money while they're traveling, you guys. Look, you guys know that I just, that wasn't even a vacation when I went down there to the casino. Next week, I'm going to Memphis. I was planning on going to Memphis during the week, but unfortunately, the deal that I'm able to get, it's not available during the week, so I'm going to have to go on the weekend. So it's going to be the 14th, 15th, and I think I'm going to check out on the 16th. I think those are the dates. I haven't officially booked it yet, but I think those are the dates that I'm going to be in Memphis. I haven't decided if I'm going to Florida or Atlanta. It's either going to be Florida or Atlanta, but I'm leaning more towards Florida. Also in July, I'm not 1,000% sure if my mother still wants to go to New York. We're going to see. Because like I said, we're only going to be able to be down there for 2 days. And I know she wants to spend more time than that with her sister. Because by the time we go to my cousin's graduation from the police academy, that whole entire day is going to be gone. So we're not going to really have any time to spend with my aunt. So I'm going to see if my mom would like to go maybe later on in the year, maybe. Because I'm actually going to surprise her in August and take her back to Florida, to Panama City Beach down there in Florida, because she enjoyed the beach when we went last month. And I just love to see my mom happy. I really honestly and truly do. That is my queen. When I tell you guys, I know that I can't give her the world, but I want to be able to show it to her, which is why I am so thankful to God that I was introduced to this travel agent industry. It is literally blessing my life more than I could have ever imagined. I would pay that $179 again and again and again. I can't go into the specifics because, you know, it's against the policy to be able to, you know, you can't really divulge that information to people who aren't travel agents, but just know that, being able to travel and earn while you travel, and it's freaking awesome and amazing. And I'm able to take my mother places and do things with my mother and just spend time with her, because we all know that tomorrow's not promised. And I don't want to be one of those people who, you know, goes and has to put flowers on her grave when she can't smell them. I don't want to be that person. I don't plan on my mother leaving here for another 50, 11 years, okay? 50,100, however many years, okay? I don't plan on my mama leaving here no time soon. I'm just saying I want my mother to enjoy the fruits of my labor while I am yet here and while she is yet here. I want her to be able to smell the roses while she is breathing, okay? So I thank God for that. So if anybody out there, if you want to be my travel business girlfriend, hit me up, okay? Girl, let me just tell you, boo, family, the couple of ladies that have already signed us to be travel agents, now that they're travel agents and they actually see what the dealio is, they were like, girl, I'm about to be somewhere everywhere. I'm like, okay, me too, for real. Me freaking too. And of course, it's a win-win for me because I'm able to travel and I'm able to share with other people, because you guys know, like I said, I've always wanted to travel and I always told you guys that I wanted to vlog. I love vlogging, but my life is so boring. All I do is work all day. So it would be pointless for me to try to vlog while I'm sitting at my desk. You know, that's boring as crap. Don't nobody want to see that. But I'm pretty sure that you guys will be thoroughly entertained while I'm out and about on my vacations, doing different things and all that type of stuff. So I'm excited about that. So yeah, I think that's all that I wanted to talk about. So yes, definitely go and update those addresses and those names. Make sure you're checking your names, making sure your name is accurate on there. If you're a guy, make sure that it doesn't have junior or senior or whatever. Just make sure that everything is accurate, because that can affect your credit score. And by you updating those addresses, you can easily increase your credit score anywhere from 20 to 60 points, all right? Now, it doesn't mean it always is going to happen. Sometimes it doesn't affect a person's credit score at all. However, most times, okay, oftentimes if a person updates their address and make sure their names are correct and everything on their credit report, it can increase your credit score. Even if it's just 20 points, who can't use a 20-point increase on their credit report? Who? Okay, who? Everybody, unless your credit score already is perfect. And I'm pretty sure there are very few people that have absolute perfect credit, except those rich folks who ain't, I mean, what type of, you know, why would they need bad credit when they got all this money in the world? You know what I'm saying? So make sure you're going and updating those addresses. The links and phone numbers will be down in the description box. Remember that you can do that online for free, or you can actually call into the credit bureau and have them update it like that. They may ask you to send in proof via fax, and just go ahead and do that. That's just a security measure. Just go ahead and do that. And yeah, let me know the results of that down in the description box down below. Go and add me as a friend on Facebook and all that good jazz, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, family.